Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and this is the Microsoft Surface Pro 7. If we take a look at the back of it here, you'll see it says Surface Pro 7 in the upper left, and this is the 10th generation. That's the new processor in here, Core i5, with 256 gigabytes of storage and 8 gigabytes of RAM. Now, this is supposed to be faster than last year's i7 model, but it's still supposed to be fanless. I do have some of the accessories. I have the new signature type cover, and this fits the Surface Pro 5, 6, and 7, as well as the new Microsoft Surface Pen. And we'll talk about these in a moment. This is the new Poppy Red color. Let's go ahead and open this up. We'll take the cover off here. Now, depending which model you get, this starts at $749 and goes up to $2,299. It can come with an Intel Core i3, an i5, or an i7, up to 1 terabyte of storage. So let's go ahead and take the cover off here. That's the box top. Now, this is the Surface itself. Let's set this aside just for a moment and take a look at what's in the box. So we have a little pamphlet here. Usually you only have the one pamphlet, and I guess this year they've included a couple different things. So it says Microsoft Surface Pro. You've got a little information guide here. We've also got this little card here, and then it looks just like a cardboard backing, I suppose. Set this aside. And then in here, I would expect we have the plug. And this is one of my favorites. Ever since Apple got rid of their magnetic plug, this is my favorite plug now, that it's magnetic, it attaches to the device. You've got your normal power adapter there, and then USB, so if you want to charge something additional, you can do that. Now, aside from that, you get the wall adapter. Depending where you live, it's going to look a little bit different, but that's all you've got, and that should charge it without any problem. So these are really nice, compact, and easy to carry. Now this year, this comes in platinum and that matte black color again. Last year I got the matte black, so I thought we'd take a look at the platinum. Let's go ahead and open this up. And this version is not too much different than what we had before. Now, like I said, this is the Core i5. It is a quad Core i5 with that new 10th generation chipset. It also has Intel Iris graphics in the i5 and i7 variants. So it's pretty decent. And then that 256 gigabytes of storage, that goes up to 800 megabytes per second in tests that I'm seeing. Now, this is created out of magnesium, and it's a pretty unique finish. It's really nice, makes it lightweight and strong. If we open this up here, we still have room for our expandable storage, and this is unlike the new Surface Pro X that comes out in a few weeks from now, but this has expandable storage. You cannot open this up. Now, the kickstand is very durable, and this scares me every time I do it, but you can push it right down, and it does feel a little bit different, like it goes a little bit further down this year. But it does bend, it's very durable, and doesn't seem to have an issue there. Now, if we take a look around the outside of it, one of the new things this year is that new USB-C port. Now, this is not a Thunderbolt port, but it does support USB-C, so you can't use an external GPU or anything like that. You have a USB-A, you have your Surface connector, so you can charge it or connect it to a dock. And then if we go around the bottom, we've got our connector for our type cover. And then on this side, we still have a headphone jack here, so that's really nice. And then on the top, you've got your power button and volume up and down. Now, this still has that really nice 12.3-inch PixelSense display, and it comes in at 2736 by 1824 with 267 pixels per inch. Let's go ahead and turn it on. So we'll set this down. You'll see it did pick up some fingerprints here. We'll let that turn on. It says just a moment. And while we do that, since I'll probably need this type cover to set it up, you'll see this is the new type cover. It's $159 if you don't get a discount on it. And this is the new Poppy Red color. So let's go ahead and open this. And inside here, that's pretty much all you get is the type cover itself. And this one is Alcantara. If you don't like Alcantara, they do have other options, but this is a new color along with a new ice blue as well. It's got that nice trackpad along with the keyboard that has pretty decent travel. This is a very nice keyboard to use. It's pretty rigid and overall looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and click it into place. And Of course, you can just close it. It fits nicely. Now, before I set this up, there is a camera on the back. This is an 8-megapixel camera along with a microphone. It can record up to 1080p in video. At the top, we have our Windows Hello sensors, dual microphones, as well as a 5-megapixel forward-facing camera. So we can use that for Skype calls or anything like that. So let's go ahead and set this up. Now let's go ahead and click English for my language here. You'll select whatever is relevant to you. Click yes. Of course, we can just tap the screen for the same thing.
Hi there, I'm Cortana, and I'm here to help. Little sign in here, a touch of Wi-Fi there, and we'll have your PC ready for all you plan to do. Use your voice or the keyboard along the way, and if you'd like me to stay quiet, just select the little microphone icon towards the bottom of your screen. If you need an assistive screen reader, press the Windows, Control, and Enter keys at the same time to turn on Narrator. Okay, enough intro. Let's dig in. Your region is set to United States. Is that right?
Yes.
Keyboard is set to US. Want to stick with that?
Yes.
Do you also type with another keyboard layout?
No.
Now let's get you connected to a network.
Now that I've put my Wi-Fi password in, we'll move on to the next step.
Next up, the legal stuff. In short, you'll need to select accept to use Windows.
We'll hit accept, or else we can't use Windows. So I'll go ahead and put in my Microsoft account credentials.
No wink required. Want to set that up now?
Yes.
Okay, hold still for a second. We need to learn to recognize you.
So it even noticed me off to the side. So we can get instant access to a phone or something like that. I'll do this part later. Then we can use OneDrive.
Files and photos to OneDrive for some added peace of mind?
Yes. So we can set up a free Office 365 home trial. I actually don't use Office 365, so we'll move on.
Hey, look, that's me, Cortana. Can I have permission to use the info I need to do my best work?
Yes. Now, of course, you don't have to allow that.
These are the settings Microsoft recommends. Go ahead and review them and select accept when you're ready.
So you can change any of these around for your privacy. We'll just leave them as default for now.
Almost done now. We just need to get a few more things polished up for you, and Windows will be all yours. Looking forward to helping out.
Now we're at the desktop, so let's click off of that. There's the default wallpaper that's set up in the background, and we have Windows new light mode here, so we can change that around if we'd like. Now this is the new Surface Pen, and this has new added tilt shading functionality and comes in at $100 if you don't get a discount. Let's go ahead and open it up here. And it comes with a battery pre-installed, and these last an incredibly long time without swapping batteries. But they're really nice. Let's see what we've got in here, if we have anything else. We have a little pamphlet here. So it says Microsoft Surface, probably some product or warranty information. And it looks like that's it. I don't see any nibs or new nibs for the tip of these, but let's move this aside. So we'll unwrap it here. There we go. And immediately it works. It says, welcome to Surface Pen. We'll hit next. Which hand do you write with? We'll hit right. And we'll pair the pen. We'll hold the top. Press and hold the top LED. Yes, we want to pair the pen. It says waiting to pair. Let's try it again. So now it says, welcome to sticky notes. I can write Zolotec. Very messy. So now as soon as I click the top, it will open up an application just like it would before. We can move this around if we'd like. You've got Microsoft Whiteboard, which is really nice. And that's really all there is to it. We'll wait for that. I guess I shouldn't try and close that out, but this is nice. It sticks to the side of the Surface, which is always really nice to carry around. Now that the Surface Pro 7 is set up, there's a few other things to mention. One of them is battery life. Microsoft says to expect 10 and a half hours or so of battery life on typical Surface usage. What typical usage is specifically, I'm not sure, but usually that's pretty much a couple hours better than what I've experienced in the past. So we'll see how this goes in the future. But this also has Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5, along with 1.6 watt stereo speakers with Dolby Audio Premium. So these are really nice devices. I am very excited to see what the Surface Pro X is like compared to this one. I was able to see them in the store today. They are a little bit thinner, but those do not have Intel processors in them. So I'm curious to see how those are compared to this device. So let me know if there's anything specific you want to see about this. I love this Windows Hello. It's super fast. I wish other companies would add this. It's just incredibly easy and convenient to use when you have to go close your laptop, open it back up and get back into it. It just makes it that much easier to use. But let me know your thoughts about the Surface Pro 7 in the comments below. And if there's anything specific you want to know about it. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.